Guys, there's a small problem.
Is it Langham?
No, it's worse than that. Come look.
Oh, George, stop being so overdramatic.
Oh, look, a goat.
You like goats?
Love 'em. Hey, we could call it Donna.
Oh, what a lovely name. Isn't it, Princess? Are you hungry, my lovely?
Okay, well, you get all David Attenborough on us. I'll take a look around. That's a Wolfram truck, which means Langham can't be far away. For a brief moment, I considered petting the creature. That moment quickly passed. The back of the truck was full of sealed boxes and crates. A knapsack had been thrown on top. I decided I should locate the owners before touching anything. Langham and his Wolfram thugs were here somewhere. Better find them first. A giant stone head lay on the ground. Look on my works, ye mighty, and despair. There you all are. But where's Langham? Psst.
What have we got here, then? Do you think the boss is coming out?
Dunno, and don't care. I was only here to blow a hole in that rock. Job done. Just waiting for me ride home.
Let's give him half an hour, max. This place gives me the willies.
Oh, don't be such a wuss. A few old statues. What could possibly go wrong? All right. Like you said, 30 minutes.
We need to get past these idiots and stop Langham.
Tricky. They've got some tasty-looking shooters. Besides, I'm a reformed man. I've given up senseless violence. Miss Collard is leading me out of the darkness and into the promised land. One day at a time.
Oh, that's great, Shears. Great. Terrific timing. I guess we're going to have to find a way past them. A large statue of a creature with a winged bull's body and a human head. Looked pretty intimidating. Another intimidating statue. I'd moved as close as I could without being spotted. Three of Langham's thugs, all heavily armed and dangerous looking. We'd need to get them out of the way if we were going to stop Langham. There was no way I'd get close to the cave entrance while Langham's henchmen were still there. Langham's men had used explosives to blast a hole in the rock face. It looked pretty dark in there. I didn't want to go down there until the guards were out of the way. I didn't want to go down there until the guards were out of the way. The driver's door was locked. The back of the truck was full of sealed boxes and crates. A knapsack had been thrown on top. I grabbed the knapsack. It was full of military items. The back of the truck was full of sealed boxes and crates. A canvas knapsack full of heavy objects. Some of them looked pretty dangerous. I wasn't sure that would open the door. That was almost a great idea. Almost. I didn't want to go down there until the guards were out of the way. A canvas knapsack. Hey, Sears.
Hello, my darlings.
What's all this stuff?
Explosives, mostly. Right little treasure trove.
Is that what I think it is?
Careful! Dynamite is fickle, unpredictable, and dangerous. Just like her indoors. No gymnastics while you got that stuff in your pocket.
I'm guessing this isn't a giant stick of gum.
Dead right, Georgie boy. It's TNT. Don't worry about it, though. It's perfectly safe. Long as you don't pull that timer cord. And if you do, give us a shout first.
If you can't repair something with duct tape, you're not using enough duct tape.
What on earth is that, Shears? It looks dangerous.
Careful. It could be anything. Gelignite, plastic, or... it could be someone's lunch.
Yeah, I think what you got there is a sausage. Local delicacy, I expect. What's that?
Fuse wire. Cut a length off, stick it in something that goes bang, light it and do a runner.
Sounds simple enough?
It is, until you make a mistake.
The classic badass lighter. I took it. I needed all the help I could get. On closer inspection, the TNT already had a detonator attached, which was distinctly unreassuring. I tore off a length of fuse wire and rammed it into the end of the dynamite. A daring act, but one that had also made me rather nervous. That was never going to work. That wouldn't have worked. Hey, Sears.
Primed and ready to go. What are you planning to do with that?
Not sure.
Come here, George. What are you doing?
I thought maybe we could use the goat for...
You were going to blow up Donner?
Well, we need a diversion, so...
There will be no, I repeat, no blowing up goats.
Putting it like that, Nico made it sound so much worse than it actually was.
I'll be having those explosives, Georges.
But...
No. No buts, Georges.
I showed the sausage to Donna. She was less than impressed.
I knew it was a sausage. Shears knew it was a sausage. But one tiny length of fuse wire and... voila! Dynamite.
Nico, a hand, please. You seem to have a bond with these creatures.
I hope you're not thinking of harming Donner.
Trust me, a cunning six-phase plan is forming, wholly approved by all the major animal rights organizations. Just keep her still for a second.
Why have you attached the sausage to Donner?
That's phase one. Now, watch as the others come together.
If it's all the same to you, I'll watch from over there.
I had a fake piece of dynamite strapped to the goat. Phase one of my plan, complete. Now, I just had to figure out phases 2 to 6. I didn't want to make myself a target without a very good reason. Once butted, twice shy. Several perfectly ripe figs. It devoured the fruit greedily. The driver's door was locked. I had an idea. I wonder just how much that goat liked figs. Hey, goat. Want a fig? It didn't work. They didn't go together.
That so didn't work. The goat sniffed the cookie, took a nibble, then spat it out. I didn't blame it. So, what are we going to do about these guys?
Perhaps you could create some kind of distraction.
Hey, Shears. Any idea how to get past these guards?
Now Nico spoiled all the fun by confiscating the explosives, I'm at a bit of a loss.
I didn't want to put that in the knapsack. Hey, Shears. Would you like a fig?
No, thanks. I don't do fruit. Apart from wine, of course.
That was never going to work. I casually tossed a fig to the bottom of the path. It was a huge natural stone arch. This whole place was amazing. We'd come this far. Leaving now wasn't an option. I didn't want to make myself a target without a very good reason. Once butted, twice shy. That should do the trick. That wouldn't make any sense. Mm-hmm. Would you like one of these figs?
Why not? Thanks.
If I wander down there, the guards would spot me. With my best throw, I tossed one of the ripe figs. It landed close to the group. None of them spotted it. The driver's door was locked. I wasn't sure that would open the door. That wasn't worth trying. The sausage already had a fuse wire, and I wasn't going to wrap the goat in it. The fuse to the sausage was already lit. The goat smelled bad enough already. I didn't want to put that in the knapsack. I didn't want to put that in the knapsack. An empty knapsack. I'd strip the knapsack of everything. I didn't want to put that in the knapsack. I'd moved as close as I could without being spotted. Three of Langham's heavily armed henchmen. We'd need to get them out of the way if we were going to stop Langham. If I wandered down there, the guards would spot me. A giant stone head lay on the ground. That was never going to work. I didn't want to put that in the knapsack. The goat wore a sausage around its neck. A fuse wire protruded from the sausage, fizzing angrily. Cry havoc and let slip the goats of war.
Oh, hello, Goatee.
Fellas, what's he got round his neck?
Looks like... Oh, my God. Scarpa!
Langham's guards must have been spooked. There was no sign of him.
In there, then? It looks dark.
I ain't going in there. Tight spaces give me the heebie-jeebies. Why don't I stay here and make sure the three wise monkeys don't come back?
The cave was pitch black, too dark to see a thing. Through the gloom, I could just see stairs leading down.
Come on, Nico. We need to find Langham.
Wow. This place is extraordinary. You think this is really Eden?
Well, if you see any apples, think twice before you eat them.
Look. Lucifer. Jehovah.
And Langham.
He's got Eva. Whatever he's up to.
I hope we're in time.
Look, the altar. The glowing thing? It's the shape of the tabula. We have to get across there, quick. The ladder was tangled in vines. I couldn't reach it from there. It was a dried-up, dead-looking bush. The lighter had run out of fuel, but the flint could still make sparks.
Charles, what are you doing?
I kind of have a plan.
Well, I hope it works.
It was a burning bush. How very biblical. A tangled mass of dry old vines hung from the ceiling. The ladder got caught up in them. The fuse wire wasn't strong enough to pull down the vines.
I needed a better idea.
That wouldn't work. The wool wasn't strong enough to pull the vines down.
Never in a month of Sundays.
That wouldn't have worked. The ancient bridge had collapsed many years ago. Langham had used a ladder to cross, but that ladder was now on the other side. It was a burning bush. How very biblical. The ancient bridge had collapsed many years ago. Langham had used a ladder to cross. I'd set the bush on fire.
Nope, I needed to try something else.
A lasso would have tangled on the vines rather than the ladder. A tangled mass of dry old vines hung from the ceiling. The ladder got caught up in them.
It didn't work. That wouldn't work. That wasn't worth trying.
The fuse wire wasn't strong enough to pull down the vines.
That was never going to happen.
The wool wasn't strong enough to pull the vines down.
I love the smell of Brett in the morning.
Don't you ever give up, but you're too late. No one can stop me now.
Do something, George. He's crazy.
No, not crazy, as you will soon see.
What are you going to do with the tabula?
It is the key that will awaken the two gods. Upon my command, Lucifer shall smite Jehovah with his power. Annihilate him.
You must not raise up Lucifer.
I must and will.
You must not raise up Lucifer.
I must and will.
You'll destroy us all.
Ha! The ancients who built these statues feared their powers, but soon I shall control them.
You can't destroy Jehovah. You'll shatter the balance. You'll plunge the world into chaos.
No. Ruled by Lucifer, man will be liberated to realize his greatest ambitions, to realize his full potential. But this isn't the place to discuss these things.
Where do you suggest?
How about eternity?
George!
Ecce homo!
Nico, you must stop him!
Eva, what do we do? I don't know.
But your father said you had the answer.
He used to talk about pure light. Your light? What does that mean? I don't know. That's what he said. Pure light, white light, will conquer. Josh!
I've been larking about, I've been thinking about supper.
How does a nice barbecue tickle your fancy?
I think you'd better have this, don't you? My father gave his life to find it. Now I must spend mine protecting it.
How? Where will you go?
To Catalonia. I have a house and a chapel to restore. And a new life to build. As a Gnostic leader.
You know, Nico, this time I really wasn't sure if we were gonna make it.
Perhaps we had the gods on our side. Or whatever those powers were.
Maybe you're right.
You know, we make a great team.
We could be more than a team.
Uh-huh.
Before this all started, back in Paris, I was just about to invite you out to...
Oi! Dinner is served!
Fantastic.
What's on the menu?
Doner kebabs with a spicy fig compote.
Wait, Donna as in... Donna?
But Nico, I thought you loved goat.
She walks in another world. I never know where she's been. She might have a twin. She's my Jasmine. She talks like a soundtrack. I wanna check the playback. She's cool and enigmatic. She's really neoclassic. Short out, my mind's a brawl in a courthouse. She's a strange girl. She walks in another world. I never know when she's been. She might have a little twist. She's mine, my
I've been wanting.